We have just introduced Sarsa. Compared to the previous TD algorithm, you can see that the two algorithms are essentially the same in form, with two main differences. The first difference is that Sarsa directly estimates action values. The second difference is that we combine Sarsa with the policy improvement step, resulting in an algorithm capable of finding optimal policies. Next, we introduce two variations of Sarsa, expected Sarsa and n-step Sarsa. While they are not as important as Sarsa, I still want to include them here to show how, starting from a classic algorithm, we can make extensions and improvements. This is a common approach for doing research. Nevertheless, if you are not interested, you can skip the part about expected Sarsa. I, however, still suggest you check the part of n-step Sarsa because it can unify TD learning and Monte Carlo learning. First, let's look at expected Sarsa. This is the algorithm of expected Sarsa. The second equation remains the same, and the first equation is also similar, with the only difference being the expectation term. Here, the expectation is taken over the action A. When expanded, it looks like this. In state ST plus 1, we have multiple actions to choose, each with a certain probability and value. According to the definition of expectation, we get this expression. In expected Sarsa, this value corresponds to the state value in ST plus 1 rather than an action value. Compared to Sarsa, the difference lies in the TD target. The TD target is changed from this equation as in Sarsa to this equation as in expected Sarsa. In Sarsa, the TD target includes AT plus 1, while in expected Sarsa, it does not. Expected Sarsa requires more computation because we need to calculate this expectation. However, since we eliminate the need for sampling AT plus 1, the number of random variables is reduced, which in turn reduces randomness. What mathematical problem is expected Sarsa solving? We know that Sarsa solves a Bellman equation. Expected Sarsa also solves a Bellman equation, but the form of the equation changes slightly. The main difference is the inclusion of the expectation term. In the previous equation, there was no expectation for AT plus 1. Now we include an expectation for AT plus 1 while keeping the expectation for ST plus 1 outside. The overall expectation is the state value V pi ST plus 1. This makes the equation clearer. Q pi SA equals the immediate reward plus gamma times the state value, all within an expectation. This is still a Bellman equation. We can apply expected Sarsa to the grid world example, where the task is to find a path from a specific state to the target state. The resulting policy from expected Sarsa would be like this. Following the direction with the highest probability, we can indeed reach the target and solve the problem. In this example, we only need to find a path from the starting state to the target. Although the policies for other states may not be optimal, we do not need to care. The figure on the right-hand side shows the learning process, where the total reward collected per episode increases over time, and the number of steps required to reach the target decreases over time. While we just introduced expected Sarsa, now let's turn to n-step Sarsa. N-step Sarsa can unify both Sarsa and Monte Carlo learning. You might be surprised to hear this, as Monte Carlo learning and TD method are very different. How can they be unified? It will be clear soon. Let's explore what n-step Sarsa is all about. First, let's review the basic definition of action value. Starting from state S and taking action A, the action value equals the expected return along any trajectory. The way we express this return is crucial. Let's look at the first way to express it. In the upper right corner, the superscript represents the first decomposition method. It means that the return can be decomposed into RT plus 1 plus gamma Q pi, ST plus 1, AT plus 1. This means we only consider the immediate reward at this time step, while the rewards from the next time step onward are summarized into a single Q pi term. Now comes the new idea. It can also be decomposed in a second way. This means considering the immediate reward at time T plus 1 plus gamma RT plus 2, and summarizing all subsequent rewards into a new qpi st plus 2, at plus 2. Following this idea, we can decompose it into the nth form, which means it equals rt plus 1 plus gamma rt plus 2, and so on up to rt plus n. After that, all subsequent rewards are summarized into qpi st plus n, at plus n. When n approaches infinity, we get gt infinite, which equals rt plus 1 plus gamma rt plus 2, and so on up to the end with no q pi term. All subsequent rewards are immediate rewards at different time steps. In fact, gt1 corresponds to Sarsa, and gt infinite corresponds to Monte Carlo. Any in-between form corresponds to n-step Sarsa. We will discuss this in detail later. Notice that all g terms with superscripts are equivalent. They differ only in how they are decomposed. If we substitute gt1 into the action value definition, we get this equation. Expanding the right side, we get this equation, which should look familiar since it is the Bellman equation that Sarsa solves. By contrast, if we substitute gt infinite into the equation, the right side becomes this. The left side is q pi. If we sample all rewards in the trajectory and sum them up to get the return, we can approximate q pi. This approach is the Monte Carlo method. Therefore, using the first decomposition, we get the Sarsa algorithm. Using the infinite decomposition, we get the Monte Carlo method. The intermediate form is n-step Sarsa, which means it may not be 1 or infinity, but somewhere in between. The resulting equation is q pi s a equals e of rt plus 1 plus rt plus 2, and so on, up to rt plus n plus q pi s t plus n a t plus n. How do we solve this equation? We use the following algorithm. This is the corresponding stochastic approximation algorithm. In this algorithm, the left side is qt plus 1 for st, at, and the right side is qt minus alpha t times qt minus this term. The difference from the previous Sarsa and expected Sarsa lies in the td target. If n equals 1, this equation becomes rt plus 1 plus the first power of gamma times qt st plus 1 at plus 1. This td target is the same as the one used in Sarsa. If n equals infinity, this equation can be transformed into a Monte Carlo algorithm. Let's see why. If we set alpha t to always equal 1, then this term becomes 1, which can be omitted. The term qt cancels out with the term on the right side, leaving qt plus 1 equal to the sum of all subsequent samples. When n is infinity, the term at the end also vanishes, resulting in the total sum. From this, we understand that by simply changing n to 1 or infinity, the algorithm becomes either Sarsa or Monte Carlo, respectively. Now let's analyze some properties of n-step Sarsa. First, all algorithms require experience samples. Sarsa requires 5 samples: st, at, rt plus 1, st plus 1, and at plus 1. At time t, we can obtain these 5 samples and use them directly. The Monte Carlo method, on the other hand, requires an infinite number of samples, or samples until the episode ends, to calculate the action value for st at time t. Naturally, n-step Sarsa is in between. It does not rely solely on the initial 5 samples, nor does it require all future samples. In addition to the initial 5, it needs these samples as well. The problem with this approach is that at time t, we do not know the future samples. So, what can we do? We have to wait. Understanding this makes it clear that n-step Sarsa is somewhat similar to Monte Carlo methods. Monte Carlo learning requires waiting until the end of the episode to update with all the data. This is why Monte Carlo learning is considered an offline method. N-step Sarsa is neither strictly offline nor strictly online. It is a special type of online method. This is because we need to wait until time t plus n to update qt plus n for st, at. The left side is qt plus n and the right side is qt plus n minus 1 minus alpha times qt plus n minus 1. This is the corresponding td target. Once we have all the necessary samples, we can implement this technique. Since Monte Carlo and Sarsa are the two extreme cases of n-step Sarsa, n-step Sarsa naturally exhibits properties that are a mix of both. When n is large, its properties are closer to those of Monte Carlo learning, with a large variance but a small bias. We have already discussed the variance and bias in detail when comparing TD and Monte Carlo learning, so I won't repeat that here. When n is small, its performance is closer to Sarsa, with a larger bias due to initial guesses, which decreases as more data is collected, but with relatively low variance. Finally, what n-step Sarsa does is to do policy evaluation. That is, it estimates the action value of a given policy. To find optimal policies, we need to combine it with the policy improvement step, similar to what we did with Sarsa.